So I get asked a lot what I recommend for assessing students' math understanding. The answer is really based upon what you are using it for. I know that we have requirements for the types of math assessments that we have to give, but often those assessments really don't give us any information that informs our instruction. So that to me is really one of the biggest reasons we need to assess students. I'm Christina Tondevold, the Recovering Traditionalist, and today we're going to take a look at the best math assessment tool that informs instruction in our quest to build our math minds so we can build the math minds of our students. Now, honestly, I don't like making this video because educators are sick and tired of assessing kids. Now, there are many reasons for this, why we're sick of the testing, because we could be doing instruction instead of testing. But I think that one of the main reasons we get sick and tired of the assessments is that they don't actually give us information that actually helps us help students. The teaching style that I promote is student-centered instruction. In this style of instruction, you base your instruction off of what your students currently understand about mathematics, and you work towards building that understanding to the things that we are kind of told they need to build, like what is the requirements at that grade level. But you start off with where your students are currently right now and the understandings they have. So if you're wanting to teach in this student-centered way, you can't just follow a textbook because it needs to be based upon what your students are currently understanding. The textbook is a resource. Yes, don't get me wrong, I'm not saying throw your textbook out, but we should not be following a textbook page by page by page. But we should instead be looking at our students' understanding and then adjusting the lessons that are in the textbook based upon our students' understandings or misunderstandings, right? So for example, if your textbook has you teaching a lesson about doubles plus one, but your students have not built their understanding of plus one, then that time that you've spent doing the lesson about doubles plus one will be a flop and it will be pointless. So that's why it's so important to assess your students' math understandings, because if they didn't know about plus one and have built an understanding about plus one, there is no sense in doing doubles plus one yet. So it informs your instruction so you know how to best use the resources you have, which your textbook is a resource. Now, I wanted to start with that so we had that foundation of that's the style of instruction that I promote, is that we should be using our students' understanding. But the way that we learn our students' understanding is through assessing them. The hard part is that typical math assessments that we have are what's known as summative. They're typically given at the end of a chapter or the end of a year to give us a summary of what kids understand or don't understand. And they're often given on a computer, right? And all that we see, and even if it's not on a computer, maybe it's paper, pencil, but all we see is the end result. We see if they got it correct or incorrect. All we see is their answer. We don't see anything about their thinking that led to that answer that we should be able to then use to help inform our instruction if we're giving it throughout the year. But again, as I said, we often use it at the very end of the year, or we use it at the end of a chapter, and we're already, like, if we get the results, we're like, they didn't do that well, but I've got to move on to the next chapter because that's what I'm supposed to do in my textbook. If we're actually wanting to use assessments to inform our instruction, oftentimes we'll look to give a pre-assessment before we start that chapter. We'll give that. But even those pre-assessments tend to only, all that we see as the instructor is the answer that kids got. So it still doesn't tell us anything about their thinking. So I want to remind you, if you didn't already know, what the Latin root for the word assess actually means. The Latin root for assess, which is accedere, means to sit beside. If you want to actually see what your students understand about mathematics, we have to sit beside and observe their thinking. Now, realistically, that ain't happening, right? You cannot sit next to every single one of your students every day to see what they are thinking. So it seems pretty impossible to be able to do that version of assess. But if we actually want to get information that informs our instruction, we need to observe our students' thinking. You don't need to sit beside every student every day, but there are tons of opportunities to actually observe your students' thinking. This might be as simple as you're standing in line, getting ready to head to lunch, and you overhear a student say something like, "We have 12 kids in our line, the other line has 10, we've got two more kids in our line than the other line." And you can make a note about, wow, that kid understood and was comparing, they knew two more than, right? You're making all of these observations about that student in an informal observation setting. Now, it could be more formal. Like you make a point that you're going to give students a story problem, and as they're working to solve that story problem, you're walking around and observing how kids are approaching the problem, what strategies they're using to try to solve that problem. When you notice, let's say that the problem is 32 plus 45, and when you have the kids share their strategies, and a kid says, "Well, I added the 2 and the 5, and then I added the 3 and the 4. And instead of just going on with that, you might stop and ask the kid, "So that 3 and the 4 that you added, is it really just a 3 and a 4? What's the value of the 3? And you're trying to pull out that, no, it's really 30 and 40 that they're adding together. That gives you a sense of their understanding of place value. So the big idea is that you're just observing and you're asking questions. You're trying to dig out student thinking that can help you make decisions about where you need to go next with their instruction. You can even become really formal and create spreadsheets about what are some things that you really want to look for. Inside of the Build Math Minds PD site, we've created these for our members, but you don't have to have formal spreadsheets. Just start observing and notating what your kids are saying about numbers. And once you start doing that, it's honestly kind of like the Math Curse book. If you've never read that book, I'll link to it down below this video. But it's like, once you start observing your students and looking for what they're saying about numbers, you will notice it all the time and you won't be able to stop. All right, I hope that this video has helped you build your math mind so you can go build the math minds of your students. Have a great day.